a starting goaltender, is 6-1-2 in his last 9 games against Montreal, 4-2-1 in his last 7 in this building.
And that would be Marc-Andre Fleury getting the nod in his country of Canada. And our Hyundai starting goaltender, Carey Price, look at his numbers, 11-3. He's got his Canadiens atop the National Hockey League point standings against the top percentage, winning percentage in the Pittsburgh Penguins. What a battle here tonight.
For the Penguins, it is the Crosby line without Pascal Dupuis. Blake Como on the wing along with Kunitz. And Kunitz chases the puck in behind the net. DK Subban there trying to get a hold of it. So is Sidney Crosby. Penguins would like to score the first goal tonight in Montreal. They're 7-0 when they score first. And then an opportunity here now with Galchenyuk dropping it off instead of shooting it. And it's a good thing. And Letang got over to break up the pass intended for Gallagher. And now Sidney Crosby goes the other way. He drops it off to Kunitz, who shoots it off a skate. And then Como fans. And it is Christian Ehrhoff on the ice, backhanding it into the Montreal zone. Close call there. Galchenyuk deciding not to shoot the puck. Olimata goes right to the bench.
No, and sometimes, you know what? That's what you want as a player. You come back from something, whether injury, something, or the surgery that he had, Staggy, you take a big hit like that. If you get up and you're okay, then you know you're ready to go.
He did go right to the bench, though. Here's Sikats coming to the goal. Big save by Marc-Andre Fleury on Yuri Sikats. Alexei Yemelin, two Russian defensemen. Not the Max Pacioretty, who's got 8 goals. He is planted on the near side by Blake Como. Big hit by Como there. Malkin helping out here. The Canadiens needed a change anyway, so Press dumped it in and went to the bench, and Malkin's got some ice to work with here as he comes galloping back to center ice. Gino into the Montreal zone, trying to go around everybody, but it comes to Hornquist. Now for Spalding, a shot, and Price made the save. He almost sneaked that one in on the short side, but Price was able to stop it and freeze it.
Couple of great opportunities, all started from behind Fleury.
And they've had scoring from 13 different players during this streak. Here's a chance, a steal, Bennett, fire, score! Bo Bennett! Right on the money, and the Canadiens see the Penguins take a 1-0 lead here in Montreal.
Wow, what a turnover. And Bo Bennett playing on that third line with Sutter and Downey. Said he was dominant down there to Mahalik.
Shot from a sharp angle by Errey. Not that it goes in, but it won't be a goal. Washed out. I think the whistle had blown long before.
It had, but or it was in the process.
The referee had made the decision to blow the whistle. And behind the net to only to Ehrhoff, and it comes right back to the right point. And Subban quickly got it to the net, and the save made by Fleury. Subban again over the Plotkin. It's a drive, and he fired it wide. And it comes up to the left point for Markov to Parenteau. He's bumped by Ehrhoff. Bennett just flipped it into open space. It's picked up now by Downey. He looks ahead for Brandon Sutter. Bo Bennett goes to the net. Now to the corner to play the puck. Made a nice move to come out of the corner with it. He finds the tang. The tang back across. Shot scores. Deep down. He puts it in. Beautiful play set up by Bo Bennett. Then the tang. Then finished off by Downey. And it's 2-0 Pittsburgh. And that third line has both goals.
Wow. What a play that was. That was incredible. I mean, I like the Bo Bennett play. And then I saw the Letang play. I liked it better.
Markov with a lead pass up the right wing. Gallagher finds Galchenyuk. His shot, and Fleury cradles that.
That's going to be the hardest play for Bo Bennett, making that play on your off wing and your own end. How do you deal with it on your back end?
This Sakas fly. Backhand shot, and Fleury makes the save. This guy can motor. Where did he come from? Undrafted?
From Kladno. There he is.
Now it's poked away by Alexei Yemelin. The Russian forward Malkin against Yellen and Gonchar, all Russians. And now here's Pacioretty coming back for the Canadiens. Zach Silt stays with him. Pacioretty strong on the puck. Comes to the front of the net. Loose around the goal. There's Malhotra, but he couldn't find the puck. Now Gilbert keeps it in for Weiss. And Mata was able to clear it. It's carried by Marcel Gotch. Craig Adams joining the rush. Gotch looks for Adams. The pass went behind him. In the middle now for Dupre, the defenseman, joining the rush. Dupre swinging to his left here. Centers, and Malkin, I think, just got a piece of that and directed wide of the goal. Hornquist comes off the corner boards with it. Hornquist centers for Spalding, and he couldn't pull the trigger. And now it's Skinneri to Dupre, a drive, and that will deflect it just wide of the goal. Canadiens are changing. Bo Bennett comes in and shoots it up. Good save by Price. But Bo Bennett, he went for the glove that time. And Price had to be sharp just to get a glove on it. And there's Dale Weiss working the corner now. Out to the point. Gilbert will sit back into the corner to Malhotra. out for Weiss. The shot just missed the net. 8 seconds to go in the period. Markov behind the goal for Grayson Bowman. And Brandon Sutter, the Penguins, hit hard by Weiss. Up the wall it comes, held in by Gilbert. For Markov, the time ran out on the Canadiens, who had something going there on their final shift of the period.
They had something going on their first shift of the period, too. They didn't shoot the puck. The Penguins came back, put a pair behind Carey Price. And then the Canadiens picked up their foot speed a little bit, and the Penguins held them off.
We'll see if the Canadiens hold true to form and get on the comeback trail, or if the Penguins can find a way to vanquish them here tonight on their home ice. They've been a good come-from-behind team and gotten off to slow starts. Maybe the teams become complacent, thinking they got the game in the bag, but the Canadiens have other ideas, so it's important for the Penguins to be aware of that. Subban moves it ahead to Gallagher. Pekanis takes the pass from Galchenyuk, but Paul Martin is there to break it up and quickly move it ahead. And here comes Bo Bennett again into the Montreal zone. Bennett snaps it right to Sutter. He scores! Another beautiful play by Bennett and Sutter. And Brandon Sutter continues to do damage against the Canadiens. It's 3-0 Pittsburgh.
Well, I'd like to be on this third line.
They're really jumping to those lanes that prevent him from getting through. There's one that hits something on the way in from OU. And now Adams with it. Adams backs it back, banks it off the wall. That's a try again. Gotch trying to move it out. Prust, whose centering pass was picked off by Malkin. Quick outlet to Gino. And then here is the Spaulding shooting. And it's up
off the bar.
I think it left the crossbar and up into the netting. So Nick Spaulding with a good look at the net. Everybody going up high on Carey Price.
Yes, and Malkin was driving the net.
Here's Hornquist with it. Into the middle now for Letang. Into the Montreal zone, he drops it off. Here's Crosby, a blast of the save made by Price. He just stood up to make the save. Now Hornquist drives it into the corner.
I've never seen him play better defensively than he did. He's unbelievable.
Here's Hornquist with a shot, and Price makes the save on Patrick Hornquist. Yeah, Paul Martin has only 3 shots in his last 8 games. Sutter up front on the penalty kill, along with Marcel Gotch. Pekanets works it down low. Right there is Galchenyuk, and Fleury shuts the door. And then the puck squirts free of Fleury. And the referee had blown the whistle. Taken there by Pekanets. Now to Pacioretty. Subban moved up on that left side. He's open over there. Gotcha to Subban. His shot kicked out by Fleury on the rebound. Martin able to clear it back to center. Pacioretty works it in behind the net. 3 seconds to go on the penalty. One more chance here. And the shot is blocked. And out of the box comes Spaulding. Gonchar chasing him. Spaulding coming to the net. His shot kicked out by Price with the right pad. He got a shot on only one hand on the stick for most of that path to the net. Here's Crosby with a backhander, and Price made the save on that. And down the wing comes Desharnais. Desharnais shoots a stick save made by Fleury. That jumped off a wide part of his paddle. Here's Como with it now. He shoots it off a leg. Right to Crosby, a drive. He went right behind Price. He reached back and found it before Kunitz did.
It hit the goalpost. It went by Price. Hit the goalpost. Came back. It wouldn't go in. And Sidney Crosby with a great one-timer in the slot.
Pekanets. And he hits Scuderi with it. Spaulding. Banks it off the boards for Scuderi. But it comes to Gilbert. Gilbert holds it. Finds Galchenyuk. Gallagher's in the slot. Galchenyuk fires it off the goalpost and then up into the netting behind Marc-Andre Fleury. The Canadiens get it back to center. Here's Letang with it with 37 seconds to go in the period. Crosby with it. Centers. Hornquist all the way through to Malkin. His shot saved by Price. Rebound Hornquist. Malkin there too. Crosby scores! Sidney Crosby gets that goal that he's been trying to get tonight. It's a power play goal and the first one for Crosby in 14 games. The first goal overall in 9, and the Penguins lead it 4-0.
Well, the Penguins may have got away with an interference. Kunitz on Malhotra up high at the blue line just outside. And he's on the power play, too, Steg, and he hadn't scored a power play goal. I think it was 14
games. Yeah. There's Desharnais in the corner now. He's hit by Dupre up the wall for Downey. And it's Dupre with it. 3 seconds to go in the period. Bo Bennett moves it towards Downey, but the time will tick away here, and the Pittsburgh Penguins have done a phenomenal job here tonight defensively. They have blocked a zillion shots by the Canadiens, and they also have a 4-0 lead through toward 40 minutes of play.
Keep doing it. That's all. Just keep doing the same. Same, same, they say.
I'll tell you, not only that, but the Canadiens have missed a lot of shots. They've attempted 40, and they've registered only 13 in the game. And even those misses, maybe some of them are as a result of players being in the lanes and just not giving them a good look at the net. Here's Pekanis shooting. And he got a redirect from Galchenyuk. And Fleury able to make the save on one of the better scoring chances we've seen.
Wow, that was tricky, but Montreal Canadiens coming out here quickly in the third period, and Galchenyuk with the redirect.
Markov centers. Arnay, Subban a blast, missed the net. Markov there, Fleury got over, and then it was pushed wide of the net. As Fleury kind of made a path over to the right, almost not too far outside the post, but no damage done. Now behind the net, Pacioretty again, over to Arnay. This is Lars Eller coming back. The thrust drops it off. Markov cross ice, a shot, and Fleury got a piece of that, I think.
Did he stop Sinkatch, that?
Sinkatch, he did. And Sinkatch with another great scoring opportunity. He's been the Canadiens' most dangerous player tonight.
I don't know how Fleury got across. This is reading that. That's just anticipating somehow getting a toe on it.
I think so. Pacioretty goes the other way. Scuderi is back. Pacioretty downshift, shoots it, and a save made that time by Fleury with the blocker. And now Erhoff pushes it over to the far side. Weiss goes over to play it for the Montreal Canadiens, and the Penguins able to get it out.
How many men on the ice?
Here's Subban shifting his weight and shooting the puck, and a save made by Fleury. And another centering pass. Paul Martin there. Fleury able to find that loose puck and freeze it. And that's one thing that Mike Johnson has complimented Fleury on all year, is his ability to find pucks in the paint. So the can handle the puck, and he'll lift it to the line, but Subban right in front. Reese, Fleury flopped to the ice to stop Pacioretty, who stepped to the front of the net, and I'm not sure he ever really got a shot off. Now the Penguins storm back. Como tried to go to Kunitz, who tried to go to Crosby. Sid diving to the ice to play the puck, and he tripped up Dale Weiss in the process. It's Kunitz with it now. Kunitz turns in front for Crosby, and he just fanned on it as he tried to steer it in behind Price. And carried over the line now by Galchenyuk, back to Markov. One pass too many, but it comes to Gallagher. His shot was blocked by Malkin. And Plekanec goes out to Gallagher. His shot missed the net. To the near side, Markov. Over across, and another save by Fleury on Plekanec. Martin gets back in defensive position now. Moves the puck to Marcel Gotch, who threw into the side of the line. Taken there by Eller. To Parenteau, to Sikach. Here he comes, he shoots it, it's Fleury the save. Another good play by Sikach. And he has been their most dangerous player again here in the third period. Bo Bennett takes over into the Montreal zone. Bo Bennett down the wing. Stops up, looks back, finds Dupre. Dupre swinging towards the net, shooting, and he just missed. Comes out to Scuderi. And our McDonald's player of the game is Marc-Andre Fleury with his 32nd shutout, 299th win of his career. And, well, you know, every time Fleury has a big game, he always gives credit to the guys in front of him. And this is one night where he can do that, and I think he can also share a lot of it. But there's no doubt that the guys in front of him blocked a lot of shots tonight, Bob.
Yeah, we're seeing this commitment to defense on a more regular, consistent basis. And I think that's what they wanted to achieve. Not only with the personnel changes they made in the offseason, but the coaching changes and what they've implemented through the training camp. So they're doing a good job of what they're trying to accomplish.